Hey, what's going on, everybody? It is Truth Tuesday. Hey, I told everybody I was a part of this little program. It's called Freedom, and it's over with. My 9 weeks, everything's over with. And I just kind of want to reflect and share with you guys kind of what I learned about myself and things I need to alter and change. First off, I appreciate all the prayers over this 9 weeks. It was an eye-opening experience, man. And I encourage any of you guys, if you ever have an opportunity to be a part of something where it's going to make you have to reflect on who you are, your relationship with Christ, and some decision choices that you've made in your life, or maybe something that you're holding on to or something that you're stuck in, I'm going to encourage you guys to don't shy away from it. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead and jump off into it. So the program is called Freedom. I'm not going to call it a program. The group was called Freedom. And like I told you guys before, we just talked about things. We looked at God's word. We looked and reflected on who we are as individuals. We built bonds with each other. We were open and honest with each other. We were transparent. We were vulnerable. We were all of the above. Uncomfortable, comfortable. We was everything. And over the 9 weeks, one thing that I realized, I really held on to the fact that I beat myself up and I blame myself for my son Asen having autism, having a disability. I've always battled with the mind frame and thought process that he has a disability due to my past sins or decisions that I've made. And, you know, I really needed to let go of that and be freed from that. And talking to these guys and just looking at scripture, I realized that, you know, chains can be broken. You know what I'm saying? Chains can be broken if you give that to God. And it's that simple. You know, he died on the cross for us, and sometimes we make it very hard. We got to make things complicated. It's just like 1 + 1. 1 + 1 = 2, no matter what you do. Give it to God, and he can break chains. Only he can break chains and create change. You know, we got a lot of people fighting a lot of different battles and stuff in their lives, and they just don't know where to go. And I was really, really defeated and beating myself up. Literally, when I look at my son, I'd be like, man, if I would have made some better choices, or if I wouldn't have done this, this, and this, he wouldn't be the way that he are, instead the way that he is. Instead of looking at him for the blessing that he is, Satan does that a lot to us. He takes our mind and our thoughts. And he knows where we're vulnerable at, and he kind of just takes like a piece of paper. He just balls it up, distorts it, and just continues to attack. And he had me to the point where, instead of me looking at my son as a blessing and all the people that he's impacted, instead of me looking at him as the blessing that he is and that he doesn't have a disability, he's just different. Instead of me looking at Ace for Ace, I was looking at Ace in eyes, in a sight, the way that I don't want anybody to look at him, and I'm his dad. So, you know, I needed to be free from that. And I'm proud to say today I'm free from that. You know what I'm saying? I would no longer blame myself for anything that my son or my daughter goes through. These generational curses that we talk about, these that we hold on to and we say that we can't break the norm. Okay, maybe you can't break it by yourself, but with Christ, you can break anything. Chains can be broken. Hence the title of this video, Chains Can Be Broken. So I just wanted to share that with you guys. I'm praying for each and every one of y'all. I don't know what chains need to be broken in your life, but I'm praying today in the name of Jesus, whatever it is, whatever chains that have you weighed down, locked in, I pray that they be broken. It's your boy Truth. I appreciate you guys tuning in always. Love you guys. Y'all have a happy Thanksgiving. Eat a lot. I'm out.